Welcome back to Cribs in the CLE. Josh and Maria live.
Our next guest has 8 Emmy Awards over the course of her distinguished broadcasting career. Her new book is called Your Voice is Your Power. We're happy to have Ramona Robinson on the show.
Ramona, welcome.
Good to be here.
No, thank you. I've never met you.
He knows you.
You are beautiful.
Thank you. I feel like I know you because we're Instagram friends.
Oh, yeah, we are Instagram friends.
I see your posts all the time, and I've been watching the show, the two of you.
Do you like it?
I love it. I love the chemistry. The energy.
Thank you.
You guys are natural.
Thank you.
Where have you been? Why did it take so long?
You've been leaving me in a dungeon, all alone.
She's been running the house, running me, running everyone, like a puppet.
I know that's a tough job, Maria.
Right. He's a little wild one. Okay, now this is your second book, Your Voice is Your Power. In the book, you write about how people deal with loneliness and depression and anxiety. Can you elaborate on why you wanted to write about this?
Well, I wrote this because Your Voice is Your Power was born out of my first book, A Dirt Road to Somewhere, and so many women, girls were asking me about, you know, Ms. Robinson, you went through so much throughout your television career, yet you kept listening to God's voice. Mm-hmm. First of all, how do you hear God's voice?
Right.
And then how do you push past that fear where you're not stuck? Because, you know, right now, a third of Americans say they're dissatisfied with their lives. Mm-hmm. That's 100 million people. And 86% of people are going to jobs that they absolutely hate.
Right.
And I found those numbers astounding.
Right.
And one of the biggest reasons is fear. People don't leave their jobs because they fear they may not be able to get another job. If they get another job, they may not like it. And it's just fear, fear, fear.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And so your voice is your power is enabling people, whatever that fear is, those negative voices, for you to push past them and ignore them and say to yourself, with the help of God, I can achieve and I can ultimately live my best life. Mm. And so I tell stories of how I did that when I was racked with anxiety or fear, how I was able to come out of a depression after I lost my mom a year and a half ago. And so there are so many stories on self-doubt, envy, social media trolls who will come
at you. The trolls.
You know what? I'm taking notes. I just don't look at them.
You're writing his notes down.
Because you're teaching. You know, you're a distinguished broadcaster. I consider you an icon in Cleveland.
I consider she is.
Just from everything you've done in the community as well. Like, you preach. You're kind of the essence of empowerment. Mm-hmm. And you give advice. And I so much love that.
Uh-huh.
And can you talk a little bit about that, your social media with you and your husband. Like,
yeah.
I feel like that is the essence of what you speak about in your book.
Well, when you're in television, you're so reluctant to give your views about things because you're supposed to be an objective journalist. Mm-hmm. But now I can say what I feel, what's on my mind, what's
Let
in my
wings
heart.
Fly.
Yes.
Yes.
And so every day on my social media pages, I try to give a thought of the day, something inspirational to get people going, or something that makes you think. Mm-hmm. And I know it touches lives. And my husband and I do Ask Us Anything,
anything
on Wednesdays, and people are asking us anything.
Uh-huh.
We try to answer them, and I realize in doing that segment, a lot of people are hurting. A lot of people don't have answers to questions that, you know, we think everyone does.
Right.
Yes.
And I tell this story about how we're bombarded with millions of voices over a lifetime.
Mm-hmm.
You know, negative voices, positive voices from God, and
Right.
And sometimes voices from our childhood that will hold us back.
You know what?
The book signing. You have a book signing
on
this Saturday.
Yeah, because people need to come in and ask you in person.
Right, this Saturday.
When is the book signing?
Well, the book signing is this Saturday at Lilly Pulitzer at Legacy Village.
Oh, wow.
And they have partnered with me to help me give back, because I'm all about giving back.
Yes. With her book, she gives back to children's charities.
I
do. 12 to 4.
12 to 4 p.m. Come on by. Get a book. It's going to benefit the Jimmy Malone Scholarship Foundation and Esperanza, which helps our Hispanic youth.
All right.
Thank you so much for
having me.
We'll be right back.
Yes.
Thank you.
You're watching Cribs in the CLE.